Thank you. Wow. How's everyone doing? Awesome. I'm glad you're all doing really well. My life's going really shitty right now, but thanks for rubbing that in. So, you know, do you want to know why my life is going really shitty?
Sure. Because
I'm pursuing my passion. That's why. I'm following my dreams. You know, they say when you pursue your passion that everything just comes together and it's all roses and sunshine, and I'm beginning to think that they are financially independent because following my dreams is leading to debt and homelessness. So, but it's good stand-up material. I think that's how I look at it, you know, like God or whoever is just constantly giving me new material. So it's really nice. But, you know, I'm pursuing acting, so which means I'm one terrible audition away from blowing the casting director. Seriously. I am. But it's funny because I've never been offered that. Like, I would do it. And where's this casting couch that everyone talks about? Like, I've never seen it. This casting couch. Anyway, that's even a bigger blow to the ego, you know? You can't even, they don't even ask you to sleep with them. But I did land one thing, and I'm proud of that. I landed a German infomercial. And it's called Shop for Slim, and it's a weight loss infomercial. Oh, yeah. And I played Johanna. And I was the unsuccessful candidate. So, and then being typecast. But that's okay. So, but you know, it's a tough industry in terms of weight, so I'm always on the lookout for a new diet. And I came across this diet pill called Ally. And it's like it's on your side of the weight loss war. You know, it's got your back. Now, the only catch is you can't consume more than 35 grams of fat per day. And let's be honest, if you're using Ally, you obviously have no self-control, so you will go over that amount. And guess what happens when you do? Anal leakage and explosive diarrhea at any time. I'm not sure it's worth it. I'd rather just eat that. But, you know, don't worry. Just be sure to carry your adult diaper bag with you, filled with black pants, Depends, and a razor to kill yourself. You know, I have a shit yourself diet. It's called IBS, and it's free. Just add some stress and some bills that you can't pay, and that's all great. So, I don't do segues, so I'm just moving on to my next joke, which has nothing to do with the last one. So, I was on the GO bus recently, and I saw this couple, and they were having an argument. And the wife was furiously waving her hands in the air. And I thought she was just being really dramatic, but it turns out she was signing because she was deaf. Now, what struck me as odd was her husband kept looking at her hands to see what she was signing. And I thought, just look away, right? Like, fight's over. Just turn her head. Right? Anyway, so is everyone familiar with autoerotic asphyxiation? I like it too. Basically, it's choking yourself while you're masturbating to increase pleasure and your chances of dying, which I guess is pleasurable for some people. Now, do the people who do this think of the consequences of their actions? Bless you. Not the dying part, but the horrific image their family and friends are left with. Like, gee, thanks, Gary, for the lasting memory of what a sick bastard you were. We had no idea. We thought you just coached Little League. Thanks for that. But, you know, I guess we all have our fantasies, and I think mine's just on the tame side. And the only snag is equality in the workplace. Now, I'm all for women working in male-dominated fields, except firefighting. Now, I want to be rescued by a tall, gorgeous man in a uniform with a huge hose, not a woman. Like, why do you think I started the fire in the first place? I need some action. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. Anyway, so, what am I talking about here? Yeah, so my friends are all married now, pretty much. And I've been thinking about it because I have nothing else to do with my time because I'm starving art. So I've thought about it, and I'm not sure I want to be saddled with one guy for the rest of my life. I mean, through thick and thin and sickness and health, I don't know. I'm thinking, you know, guys always say, why buy the cow when I can get the milk for free? And I say, why buy the whole pig when I just need a little sausage? It's revolutionary. So, since I seem to attract the real winners, I have come up with my own little self-defense system. So, I carry a little mini spray bottle with me filled with my favorite male cologne. And in the event of an attack, I will spray the perp in the eyes, blinding him. Hopefully. And if it doesn't work, at least it makes for a more pleasurable experience. And listen, if you can't get them off of you, at least get yourself off.